Hello everybody, welcome to Corner 4 Billiards, a place where you can grow as pool players. If this is your first time here, please consider giving a like, a subscribe, and let's get into today's topic. Hey guys, I'm Bryant, your online teammate, and today we're going to talk about some of the scenarios that have come up during my teammates' matches or my client matches. I often watch them play, and I love doing teachable moments with them. So I always find something that they did in a match that I would have done differently. So we're going to share some of these scenarios today. We're going to do three scenarios. We're going to show what my teammate did or client did. And we're going to talk about what they could have done differently. Okay. Now, I know some of these shots, your high skill level is going to be like, well, that's a no-brainer. You know, I don't think that way. I don't expect twos and threes to know what a seven know, okay? But the point of this video is, you know, you don't have to be a gunslinger. You don't have to make every ball, okay? So these are just some of the scenarios that I think would be really beneficial for the lower skill level players to check out, okay? And, you know, at the end of the video, if you guys like to see more of these, please leave the comments down below and we can do more of these. So we're going to set the table up and get ready for the first scenario, guys, and let's get right into it. Okay, guys, here's the first scenario that came to my mind when I decided to put this video together. All right, my guy was on stripes, and this is his layout, okay? He got the 9 ball here. He got the 15, a quarter inch off the short rail, and he got the 12 ball here. So what he did was he tried to make the 12 in the corner. And this is what happened. This is exactly what happened. He ended up stretching and giving his opponent ball in hand. All right. Now, his opponent didn't run the table, but his opponent did win the rack because the opponent ran by 4 balls off and then ended up playing a safety on my guy to get ball in hand and end up winning the rack. All right? So, what could have my guy have done differently? All right? Let's set it back up. Now, so what he could have done, you know, he had to realize that, you know, you don't have to make every ball. Remember, don't be a gunslinger, all right? So I just told him after his match was over, I said, man, you could have came here. Play defense, give yourself a chance to get ball in hand. So now, his opponent can't see the 3. And he can't see the 5 either. And he can't see the 1 ball. Now, who knows what would have happened after this? You know, maybe his opponent tried to kick at it and miss the whole ball and get ball in hand, which is what he want. Or maybe he could have just tried to touch it and make contact with the ball. Who knows what happened at that point. But if you don't touch it, you get ball in hand, you give yourself a better chance to get this cluster and you get a chance, you know, just a better chance to finish your table off. Okay? Now there's one scenario. Now I'm gonna set up the next scenario. Okay guys, here's the second scenario. Now, and this is from a different player, but he's on the solids. His opponent, you know, overcuts the 9, or I don't remember if he overcut or undercut it, but the 9 ended up coming here and bouncing here in front of the pocket and leaving my opponent this. So my opponent has solids. He has the 1 here with the 9 blocking the pocket. He got these 3 solids here in front of the 8. So, but what he did was he tried to shoot the two ball, so he came here. And he missed. So, his opponent came around here. He makes the nine. And he came over, come out to here. And he didn't leave himself a shot, but he had to bank it. And he ended up missing the bank. But I don't remember the results of that rack, but I just remember this specific scenario. So, I'm gonna set it back up. Now, what he could have done differently, two things he could have done. So, one thing he could have done is he could have came here. Might be a little short. So, he could have came here and simply go there. So now the opponent is hit. So now the opponent is forced to have to, you know, come up the rail or try to kick at it. Okay. Another option he could have done is he could have came here and he could have play defense that way. So now the opponent, it's the opponent's shot, but now the opponent have the eight ball to try to get to. So now the opponent, instead of shooting at his nine, he had to try to figure out a way to get to the eight. And we don't know what would happen after that, but he would probably try to kick it, you know. But no matter what happened, if you don't touch it, you get ball in hand. Now you got an open table. You gotta worry about nothing. So that's what I recommended to him after that rack. All right. That's the second scenario. All right, I'm gonna go set up the third scenario. Okay, guys, this is the third and final scenario for this video. This is a nine ball rack. This comes from one of my female teammates. The three is right here. The four was right here. Tangled up with these balls over here. And the five was over here. So what she did was she tried to bank the three ball. And I asked her, you know, after the match was over, what was she trying to do? So she said she tried to bank it cross side and leave the four ball, the cue ball over here somewhere, so she can at least try to kick it and touch the four. So what happened was she did this. And she ended up hitting it too soft. Came over this way. So she ended up hitting it too soft. So not only did she leave her opponent a shot in the side, but she also left her opponent an opportunity to break this four out of her. So her opponent is a three or something, I think, two or three. Her captain calls a timeout on her. And he simply told her to use top on this ball and run it to the three, and the opponent was able to try to kick the four out. You know, of course, the three, they didn't run the table or nothing, but it was just a good opportunity to get a breakout. So, what could have my teammate done different? All right, let me set these back up. What could she have done differently? I mean, I know the high skill of players already know what to do, but at some point we didn't always know either, so there's no need to say, oh, that's simple, man. Anybody know to do that? You know, no, you can't say that, you know, and it's not fair to say that, you know, because you understand it. You know, you can't expect threes to play like sevens and eights. You can't do that. So, what could have my opponent done differently? So what she could have done, and this is the only thing that I could have think of, is just send the cue ball and three ball opposite ends of the table. All right. So what she could have done is try to cut the three more, and instead of trying to bank it here, she could have just cut it more here to send the three ball this way. You know, well, in this case, I didn't hide it, but she playing a three, so that still would be a tough shot for a three. All right. And to backtrack, I didn't tell her this already because she already used both of her timeouts. So she called timeout early. So she already used the timeouts. So again, she could have came here, put the three over there. You know, she probably wouldn't have executed it just like this where the opponent is hit, but it don't matter. Even if the opponent can see it, whatever, it still would be a tough shot for a lower skill of the mate. All right. Okay, I'm going to grab my chair and do a recap. Well, guys, that's it for today. Just keep in mind, guys, you do not have to be a gunslinger, okay? We are not professionals. You know, we can't all run tables, so we have to be smart. You know, you don't have to be the strongest shooter at the table on that night to win. All you got to do is just be smarter than your opponent, all right? So don't be a gunslinger. No, you do not have to make every ball, okay? We want to take high percentage shots. We want to take shots that can get us positioned on the next ball. You know, a lot of shots, that's tough. Yeah, it may be a tough cut shot. It may be a bank shot. Yes, the shots are makeable, but you have to understand where your cue ball go if you make it, okay? So just give yourself an opportunity to get to the table more, all right? I don't expect the lower skill level to know how to do kick saves or send a cue ball or object ball three rails to play defense, okay? I know the high skill levels, you know, some of these scenarios, you may have been thinking, you know, anybody should know that. But I don't treat people like they supposed to know something, all right? You can't treat a skill level two and expect them to know what a skill level seven knows, okay? So, but this is why I build a channel. It's for the guys, you know, I want to be your online teammate, all right? I'm here to help you grow, you know? But keep that in mind. I hope this video was helpful to my lower skill levels. I want to thank my sponsors for everything that they do. And I want to thank you guys for being here. And if you guys are liking the content, please consider giving a like and a subscribe. And hit the bell. You get a notification every time I put out a new video. All right, guys. If you like me doing videos like this, leave me in the comment. I can do more scenarios in future videos. Okay? Guys, until next time, please continue to take care of each other, take care of yourself, and I'll see you next time.